and you have to play just so many more games than everybody else. You have that looming thing over your head.
So here's Cole going against Secret. Cole not looking to be the next Archon here, as they can edge it up. Now this is going to be an interesting thing, because I've been very curious as far as drafting Edge. I mean, you got God tier puppy, of course, Hall of Famer in the, you know, as captain of Dota history. And then the other team just have Swindles, who many people agree that Swindles is a fantastic drafter. You know, they would say that his drafting and captain capabilities is far above his Dota. This is what people say.
Your delivery was, and then you have Swindles.
Come on, guys.
You cannot stop laughing.
Well, don't deny me. That's like, you know, this puppy and there's David Swindles as far as legacy.
One more time, please. Just do it again.
Puppy is just a fantastic drafter. And
the resume is the resume.
Yeah. If you're looking at resume on one team, it's one thing. But if you look at, like, you know,
you're just like digging that hole a little bit deeper.
Make it sound
you're
better.
Not letting me finish the point. That's why it sounds like I'm going so deep.
It's way better this way. You just look like a giant flamer now.
Yeah, you're just all interrupted. And now he looks like he's insulting Swindle.
No.
I was going to give Swindle more credit because I feel like him and his team are more in sync, and he could draft for them as a team better than
right,
maybe Puppy can do.
We got a draft going on, guys. Come on.
You guys are terrible co-pilots on this ship, let me tell you.
That was all LD right there. Yeah. Just could not stop laughing looking at your face right now.
And then you Swindle.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, Puppy is the more accomplished captain by a long shot. That's the whole RTK Swindles thing. Like, say what you will about RTK, the man has proven on land before. Sure, maybe now he's a little washed up. Don't think too many people would argue with the recent results being subpar, but
the
he's
team,
entitled.
The,
he's entitled to talk.
The point was, the Swindle know his team better than what Puppy knows with this new team. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, he's played with someone like Pileidai and you know, a little bit here there with Bulba and of course Arteezy. But, you know, Swindle has been with tight-knit with his Complexity crew for many a day.
I will say it quickly, because I know we want to talk about the picks. The one thing I will say for Complexity is I feel like they have less cooks, for sure, than Secret. Mm-hmm. Envy has very strong ideas about how to play the game. Artur does as well. Yeah. In some ways, they share a vision for the game. On the other side, you've got Puppy, of course, with his own ideas about how Dota should be played. And, you know, sometimes too many cooks can be really productive. You can have lots of different ideas and a bunch of varied strategies. Like, I think Secret, when S4 was on the team, we saw that at times where they had all kinds of cool pocket picks and different styles, but it can also be counterproductive. For Complexity, there is one voice that is Swindles. Everyone else will contribute and have input, but, like, when you look at how they play in practice, like, he's the guy in charge, so.
Yeah.
Well, fortunately for them, Secret are running a drought strategy, so that, I think the drought has had a lot of success because I think, like, everyone is pretty much on the same page on how to play drought strats, and it's very easy to execute. Like, everyone knows, take towers and snowball from there, right?
Yeah, take towers, pick, like, two ranged cores at least that benefit from the drow aura. You usually want to ban versus, like, the team you want to be, like, that you're playing against. You pick Drow, you want to ban Winter Wyvern.
You get that one defensive support.
Yeah, one defensive support. Exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, looking at the bans in this game, like, they all make sense for the most part. Like, Ricky Darkseer, of course, like, Team Secret, just, Ricky's pretty much banned every game. Darkseer is one of the ones that is a bit of a changeup, but Complexity has a very good win rate on it. The Wyvern, like we mentioned, very good versus Drow. Tinker is a bit of the change ban just because they have a Beastmaster. They don't want to be playing versus that global potential. Then looking at Cole's bans, I mean, kind of straightforward as well. The Void Elder Titan were two heavily picked heroes in the first phase. The Storm synergizes very well with Drow, like we're mentioning, ranged core as well, and then the Terrorblade with the Shadow Demon. All these bans are just very systematic and straightforward from both teams.
Yeah, we've seen quite a few teams go for, like, Dusa together with Drow. Well, not sure what Secret have in mind to combo with it, but it's really open-ended. You can pretty much do whatever you want once you have this pick.
Are they bringing back Enigma? Are they going to bring back Enigma?
Oz?
Us? A Secret.
Oh, Secret, you mean.
I mean, when they did, they used to do it, like, in the first phase, right? I mean, like,
yeah, they used to.
I mean, Rana is going to be the other range core, though.
Could still be Puppy playing it.
Yes,
He does tend to play those roamers.
Could have the peanut butter and jelly team of Mirana, Shadow Demon, roaming about. Of course.
How do you feel about this Earth Spirit pick? He's been having... He still gets picked, like, sometimes in the first two from certain teams specifically, but overall, his impact's been very lackluster to me.
Look how relaxed Swindles is.
He's really relaxed. Maybe too relaxed. I mean, I said take the edge off.
He likes it. How do you feel about that, Ben? How do you feel about the Air Spirit pick into Drow?
It's really tough. I think it's a really slippery slope because they don't have any setup for him. Like Darkseer Void, I think, or ET. I think any of those three would be like amazing combo with him. But I think he has to do too much on his own.
I'm curious because it's interesting the way you obviously disable the Drow aura as soon as you get in on top of him.
But then
you just die, and the gust is like super good versus Air Spirit. So I could see like why it can be cool. I'm kind of interested to understand why Melons would pick that in the first.
Because Z-Freak loves this hero, dude.
Yeah, it is.
Because he likes to play it and he wants to play it, and they still think it's the hot four position right now.
Yeah, I mean, okay, that's fair enough for me.
That's all I could think of. I mean, most teams have just kind of like, we're good on that. We're gonna move on. Like we see OG, like Crit used to play it every freaking game, and they decide like, we're good.
I mean, I will say when Complexity has dominated, like when they beat EG, 2-1, Z-Freak went off. He was Morana one of the games, hit like that crazy blind arrow into the trees up on the top side of the map, if anyone remembers it. And
I remember that. Yeah.
Like, those are the games to me where Complexity has taken down, you know, top tier competition or teams that were viewed as like, you know, creme de la creme is when Z-Freak goes off, and Earth Spirit is one of those heroes he can go off on.
I mean, even at TI5 last year, the like famous Enigma play that kind of like brought him out to a bunch of people. He sold his mech, bought a refresher, refreshed his black hole, and gets a
He's their DJ. Like, he's
like
the guy.
Sickest play ever.
He's the guy that needs to take over the game. I think Complexity is a little more dependent on Z-Freak than Fnatic is on DJ, although lately with Mushi struggling, they've become more dependent on him, but yeah. So Dazzle gets picked up, and now Secret working on pick number 4. Very Drow, like just the whole strat centered around the Drow at this point. They are pretty light on team fight or sustain, really, but there you go. They get the
Tidehunter. Okay. So that just gives them a little bit of team fight and just roundness to their lineup. Complexity instantly go for a Slark. I was actually going to comment about the Dazzle pick. It's cool. I actually like it a lot versus the Drow just because of Weave. Obviously, it's very good versus it, and just the combo, if someone gets arrowed up, you can always grave them up, especially if they're just like a support or something, save them with that.
And Dazzle's been seeing a lot of mileage lately for a lot of teams. I've been seeing so many times now, we saw it a lot in the Na'Vi Fnatic game, just grave and TP bailout, and just ruin so many ganks. Such a nice little versatile here to have.
So obviously, like, later on in the game, Slark is a really annoying matchup for Drow, because he normally gets a mobility item, he's very good at staying on her, difficult to burst. But do you think they can get to that point where Slark comes online? Because this is obviously a push strat already.
Most of the time I see it, Slark's like way too slow.
Yeah.
Like he has like one item, and then Drow's already taking down all the T1s, and then gets Rosh, especially because they're in Dire.
And Slark tends to struggle more against five man, which is in the early to mid game, which is clearly what Secret are looking towards here.
I also think he struggles versus the Shadow Demon. Like,
exactly.
Shadow Demon's very good versus the Slark. Yeah.
He struggles a lot to get into this lineup too, and if he does even get in, if the Tidehunter is like very aware of his positioning, he's always going to have to stick on the Slark and then massively disrupts your damage.
They need more team fight, I think, or anti-push. I think the Dazzle and Earth Spirit are kind of cool, but I really just don't see anything really stopping the Drow push.
So what is available that could slow it down at this point?
Crosswalks Invoker, I think, is always pretty decent, but
kind of a Chessy classic, yeah.
What else is there? I think they play really well around Death Prophet, although
it was
with
banned
with the recent nerfs.
Secret, it was a good ban by Secret.
What else do they play? Mid.
Mid with creep spam and push of their own.
And we already mentioned the Invoker, so. I mean, they have ran Dragon Knight, not too much.
More armor,
yeah. Tanky, actual tower hitter.
I actually kind of like the Wisp Bristle versus the Drow Ranger, but it's way too late.
The setup isn't there anymore for it, unfortunately. And they banned the Timbersaw too, so it could be the Dragon Knight. Or maybe they could do something else.
Maybe
completely.
Too. Maybe more armor.
Legion Commander? I'm reaching, guys.
Yeah. It's Complexity, it's gonna be a Jhin hero. Yeah, who knows?
Well, Legion Commander removes the arrow. I don't know. I'm totally reaching.
Yeah, it needs to definitely be a tanky one. I like the idea of the DK, but I wonder if that's too much melee core for him.
Gives him a building hitter and a guaranteed stun, but...
Yeah, you don't know how Secret's going to lane this. It's clearly going to lose to any ranged hero.
Doesn't give you much damage either, which they're kind of lacking on their lineup a bit. Okay. I actually did not... I was going to say Tiny just because it's, you know, obviously the Limp Tiny is one of the most famous ones, but I don't... Does Chessy usually play the Slark, actually? So maybe Chessy does always play the Slark, so that's why they're going to go and switch it up. Okay, interesting approach.
I mean, it's a lot of burst damage, something that can just instantly blow up the supports. Not the best steep push. Like, the Tiny this game to me is the one that has to snowball to create space for the rest of the team. Like, you need a decently timed blink so you can go around and make things happen.
I think it's blink, the Tiny's items are going to come too slow, though. You're going to be matched up versus Murano with Drowar, and then if Shadow Demon comes in, like, you're just dead.
You struggle a lot in that lane versus Murano anyway.
Really hard lane.
Like, you have like, no armor whatsoever on Tiny. It's a very...
Craggy level 1 with Pro Man Shield.
Okay. Your poor man's Dragon Knight right there.
I wonder what Seeker are going to get now for their possible response, though. Do we bank they're going to put the Murano mid? No, right?
They could run a DK.
It could be a support, but...
It looks like it is Murano mid now.
Alright, yeah, Murano mid's nice because, you know, roaming Earth Spirit, you need to find someone who could avoid the trouble of early harassment a bit, I suppose. She fits that bill nicely, and we get to have a classic pickup here in the Puppy Enchantress.
SD Enchantress to move as well. That's nice roaming supports.
Yeah, and they have, aside from the Drow, the Murano and Tide are pretty sustainable and difficult to bring down the laning stage.
All right, gentlemen, this is where I ask, what are your predictions for game number one of Secret versus Complexity? LD, we start with you.
Ooh. I like Secret's draft better. I think it's pretty much all on the Earth Spirit in the laning stage, and then Tiny come mid-game. I just worry about the Tiny's lane. I don't see where he's going to get the farm.
I worry about the Tiny's lane and the Slark's lane, I think. Yeah. I don't think it particularly matches that well versus Tidehunter, and they have an Enchantress. The Drow's have just been winning, like, everything lately, so I have to go with Secret.
Yep, I'm a bit worried for Complexity's timings. I think that they don't really have any deep push, and I think Secret will be able to just push down their towers and get a good enough of an advantage where the Slark won't be able to come back.
Will you stand for Complexity, Dakota?
I will not, sir. I'm going to go with Secret on this one. We'll see if their debut since the qualifiers is going to be as livid as we expect, or will Complexity be able to start strong with a Game 1 victory. We'll find out soon. We throw it over to that right couch now. It's LD and Merlini who are going to bring you the casting, gentlemen. Have some fun.
All right, Ben. Game 1 of this best-of-3 showdown. Secret on the Dire side facing off against Complexity. The wildcard team heading into the International Secret looking to get some practice in before the group stages begin here at Star Ladder. So, Z-Freak, early on the move, has managed to block off a camp here, trying to limit what Puppy can get done as the Enchantress is starting towards the bottom side.
Are they smoked up?
Yeah. And they're wrapping around.
They're in really deep, and I think they're starting off aggressive with Enchantress. This is going to be very difficult for Complexity to deal with.
Yeah, he did block that one camp towards the bottom lane, but Puppy's already in the jungle, so there's plenty of other creeps he can access here. Seeing this aggression, do you look to change up the lanes at all?
The Earth Spirit generally would try and roam around early. I think you need a match to Enchantress's movement, try and pop the smokes. Does Puppy even have a smoke on him early? Possibly.
There's that poor man shield that you mentioned.
Yeah, he definitely needs it. So I think you have to protect your two melee heroes. Beastmaster, you kind of just leave alone. It's like, whatever. Looks like he actually is going to... Actually, they're doing different lanes.
They want him to deal with the roaming, it looks like.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea. Like, as
you
long
have the
as
Hawk
Beastmaster
to scout the Enchantress movement if it's in the right position.
Mm-hmm.
And but obviously, if he dies, not the biggest deal.
At the same time, though, the Slark isn't going to be a great matchup against the Drow Ranger. Actually,
well,
it's
looks
tied.
Like he's gonna lane against Tide.
Everyone
here.
Has swapped
musical lanes here. Complexity running the Beastmaster in the safe lane, and to mirror it, Secret running their own offlaner, Mr. Bulbon the Tidehunter, up in his own safe lane. So, effectively, since they've both done the lane swap here, it's kind of the standard matchups you would normally expect just on the opposite side of the map.
But this leaves the Slark much less vulnerable to the Enchantress, at least the aggressive Enchantress lane. And if he goes for the Slark, then the Tiny's going to be a lot more safe. So I think the Enchantress can only pressure one of those two, which is pretty important in this early game. And I think the Tide is also going to struggle a lot versus the Dazzle Heal Bomb in his own safe lane.
So it does leave the matchup I think we were mostly expecting here, which is that Tiny to be in the mid lane with the Drow.
He's ready. He's ready to go. Enchantress is right there.
Primed for Limp. Is he going to find the opening? He moves in slowly with the Frost Arrow skilled up nice and early here. They're trying to get in range for a Centaur Stomp. The Limp just calmly backs away, makes it up to the safety of his own hill. Still, the early pressure will make life a bit more difficult for that Tiny. We'll see now the Centaur harassment from Puppy, so not able to find a first blood, but he is certainly looking to secure the mid lane nonetheless.
How's Beastmaster looking? He doesn't have Disruption at level 1. He opted for the poison, but he is already level 2
have it now. Looks like they maybe want to kill off that boar and then go for the disrupt into arrow combo. Arrow coming through. It's a nice connection there. Good surround by Pylaidai. Swindles going to have a very tough time making it out here with the leap coming through. Swindles will be brought down. So first blood to Secret. Pretty straightforward stuff there from the Shadow Demon Mirana.
However, it's really bad though because he doesn't need the help of an Enchantress. So Enchantress can free up the mid and top lane. This way they can win all three lanes if Enchantress isn't even needed on bottom.
And of course top, you've got a Slark versus Tide, and Tide just great against almost all melee heroes at this stage of the game.
And Pi's playing really well against the Beastmaster too. He's like really focusing on the boar because that's one of the few ways that he can get out of the disruption into arrow combo. So he's prioritizing that, getting stacks up with the poison like as soon as possible. And Z-Freak struggling to neutralize this early game threat of the Enchantress.
And you gotta see Pylaidai looking to contest even the pole's bottom, but Z-Freak gets scouted out here by Puppy, and despite his double damage drain, has to roll away.
Also, the wards that Complexity have placed have been rendered very useless. It's like the one near the right side and this one, but Enchantress is on the top side of the map, so they, Secret has completely dodged what Complexity expected from them in the early game, and this allows the Enchantress to hit a lot harder.
Well, you mentioned losing all three lanes. Right now, Slark is doing very well. 17-4 up top. Having a fantastic time. Lip still CSing pretty well. Given that their other cores are farming well, do they need to make an adjustment or should they just stick with what they have?
As long as they don't lose heroes in the bottom and mid, I think it's okay, but I don't know. Swindles is like not getting that much at all out of this lane.
Yeah, Pi's doing a really good job at zoning him, and we saw in that last engagement, able to juggle harassing Swindles with also killing off the boar to ensure that arrow didn't get blocked by it, so handling the matchup quite well here so far.
They could lose control of their jungle right now, though. If Swindles dies to the smoke gank, they could be in for a lot of trouble. He does have a TP scroll that might be able to save him. I think he only has a Satyr creep with
pretty,
him right now.
Pretty good position here to reveal Puppy, and the boar is going to scout him out first and foremost. So nice job there by Swindles with the 4-minute rune about to spawn of seeing what's coming and dodging away. Still, though, Puppy able to take over the jungle. Swindles forced back quite a bit. We see Envy lane a bit here to limp.
His CS is actually very good, the Tiny with the 4-man shield. And there is a Haste Rune available up top. Earth Spirit looking like he wants to wait. This could be a very important kill on the Drow Ranger. Has she skilled Gust at all? Or just Frost Arrows? So 2-0.
Already 2-0-3. No, not saving a skill point.
She's not topped off though, and they have full vision of her because they deserve reward.
And this
so
is a matchup that can snowball. You die once or twice, the Tiny gets the move speed advantage, and down you go. Avalanche, toss. Will he need the Earth Spirit assist? He will. Boulder Smash coming through. That's a nice connection. Good disruption there by Pylaidai. Will Envy be able to make it out? Jukes through the trees. One more swing will bring him down, but Z-Freak also low in turn as Limp, Hasted will try to run away, but Puppy's there to cut him off. They keep on looking for poison spam, but Pylaidai doesn't have the stacks required. It looks like Limp will make it out. Z-Freak to deny himself to the neutrals, a nice clean take there in the mid lane, forcing two support rotations, and they get the kill.
I'm not a big fan of the two Frost Arrows in the mid lane. I think in the safe lane it's very good because you have a lot more chasing room, but like in the mid lane, like when you actually start to hit hard with marksmanship, is generally nighttime, and they don't have a ward up the hill, so he can't actually harass them that well. And they're just not that much chasing room. You can chase like maybe like 700, 800 range, but with the one level gust, it would have at least been a lot closer in terms of the death. But not a big deal. It's very good if you want to keep harassing the Tiny.
Well, Swindles, he's becoming the punching bag here for Secret. At least that's the goal as they move in onto the Beastmaster. Leap forward from Arteezy, has the arrow ready. Let's it fly. It will connect the level 3 Starfall as well. Tough to juke there at that point as he was pretty far committed to the tree line, but unable to dodge the arrow, will go down.
Yeah, if he had an Iron Talon, maybe he could have eaten that tree and hit in that pocket. That's a tough gank to dodge.
Yeah, he kind of like pinned himself there up against the trees, unfortunately. Now the tower likely to drop his Puppy, taking point on this one. Last hit will go to Arteezy most likely as the disruption comes through. They set up with another arrow, another connection on Handskin, and down he too goes, and the tower as well. So Complexity giving a little something extra away to Secret. 3-1 now the score. All the while, Bulba just getting his levels up top. He's hit 6, has the Ravage. You gotta figure, Ben, that Secret are just gonna keep this pressure up now with the Drow Ultimate also available. They can just keep on pushing.
And the Tiny was doing very well. He was like 17 CS when Drow had 15, I think. And now Drow has caught back up and then some, despite dying. So that's actually quite surprising. And Chessie, not sure what ability he's going for yet, has saved up a lot of his gold and just going for a lot of small items. But
do you see him being able to get anything that's not just like a very cheap fighting item?
I think for example, if he goes Midas, I think they're in like really bad shape. But
I have seen him do it before in games like this, and it did not work in this type of matchup against a really heavy push lineup.
Yeah, they just don't have a way to deal with Enchantress, so sometimes you'll see like Slarks pick it up versus like a Chen slash Enchant, but I think by the time he gets it, like the Enchantress will already have done most of the damage, and she'll still hit very hard without the creeps because of Drow Aura, she's high level.
Bulma here, trying to bully Handskin a bit. Swindles has been scouted out, they've used the Moonlight Shadow to get vision on him, good disruption. Follow up, Starfall will come through, and with the Soul Catcher, it's an easy takedown.
They, like, I don't really know where Earth Spirit has been, but they really need him to, like, the Secret's just doing everything with the supports, and I don't know whether he's, like, trying to react to ganks, whether he's trying to pick a level 6, whether he's trying to, like, stack for Tiny, maybe, but I'm not really feeling Z-Freak doing what he normally does in the early game, and Secret are kind of, like, challenging Complexity. We're going to do this with Earth Spirit, we're going to dive you under towers, we're going to take control of your jungle, we're going to push your towers, and Complexity haven't really been able to respond with anything even remotely fearsome.
Well, you want to see something out of their spirit. He pokes his head out in the mid lane, does drop a ward. There's just not many easy objectives to be claimed here. It's not like you want to go on the Tidehunter. The Mirana, just very safe with the deep wards that Secret have managed to plant down, so...
I think they need a lot of kill runes. They need more kill runes on the Tiny. Like, he had the haste that was there, one kill on the Drow Ranger, like, more invis runes, more haste runes, I think is... even Arcane Rune, I think, is really good on Tiny, and then they can... kind of use him as that engine to get that blink dagger, get their level 6s on their supports, and just get more items up and not die as much as...
Oh, Swindles caught out again. The disruption is going to buy time for these TPs that are coming in, though. Arrow will connect, but the turn from Limp, looking for a bit more with Z-Freak joining the fray as well. Will they be able to get the follow-up? Boulder Smash, they do, and then they latch onto Arteezy. They will bring him down. Chessie almost dying. The Slark explodes in the midst of it. The double Starfall will end up dying to the Mirana, but Z-Freak chasing forward again, has the Boulder Smash ready to go here in just a moment, is going to try to focus the Pylite die down, chasing deep on the Shadow Demon. Puppy just kind of ignoring it, farming up the mid lane here. A long toss, Swindles in deep, he whips on the axes on the way in, but drags them back on the way out to secure the kill. Will end up costing them the Beastmaster as Limp sacrifices him to Secret. In the end, there are 2 for 2, but it's 2 cores for a support and a core, and the tower also dropping.
Some nice movement by Arteezy there, as well as a nice restraint on the boulder from the Earth Spirit. He was like trying to dodge it, and unfortunately for them, Chessie actually dies there. That was... And did not expect Slark to get double hit by the Starfall there.
I don't think he expected it either. Yeah. That was brutal. So, at this point, you mentioned kill runes. Beyond that, what are you looking at for Complexity? They've lost 2 towers early to Drow. We've yet to see a Ravage this game. It does seem like Secret have the map control advantage.
Not toss the Beastmaster in. That would also help.
So get haste runes and don't throw Beastmaster.
They need to get more kills with Roar. Like, yeah. Beastmaster, he really struggled in the bottom lane. He's not going to have time to farm his jungle because he already lost 2 towers on bottom, so that entire bottom jungle is just not going to be that safe for him. I guess he can try and farm it out because it is pushed very far into Complexity territory, but this leaves like Slark kind of out alone on the top lane. But like as of right now, they need to stop the train. Like in the next few minutes, Secret are gonna keep taking down the T1s. They haven't yet used Ravage, which is a great worry, and they also have Roshan access very easily on the Drow Ranger. Should she choose to go for HOD, she can solo herself. They have the Wolf. They might not even need to take down the T1s. They can just do it right now. She did go for Mask, though, instead of the Dragon Lance, and this build is much better if you want to do Roche.
And having just killed the Hawk here, Secret feel quite safe to move into that Roshan pit. Swindles,
they have a small window.
Has another
right now,
summon available. Has not chosen to bring it out just yet. But
if they scout it out right now, then they can fight before the Tidehunter gets there, because he's healing. But
this is going to be a pretty safe Roche, though.
No, they don't have Tidehunter there. This could be really bad for them.
Puppy's still at relatively low HP, but Envy rather healthy. The backup is coming, though, now. Shadow Demon gonna be the first one in. Quick TP out. Envy, nope, not gonna happen. Swindle slams the door on that, gets the roar up. The heal bomb comes through. Arrow, though, hitting only the boar. They'll use the Moonlight Shadow to try and disengage, but Bulba's here. The frontline tanker, he gets off a Ravage, connects on 3. They're gonna bring down the Earth Spirit, looking for a bit more. Swindle's low, great grave there by Handskin to keep him alive, but is he able to turn the battle? Chessie also dropping low to impetus damage as he lays into Arteezy. They've only so far gotten the Enchantress kill. A 2-for-1 thus far, but with Ravage committed, they can look for a bit more. Bulba low, up and down, the watermelon will crack. Complexity hang on, they prevent the Roshan. And the Ravage is down now, Ben, so Secret might think twice about walking back in.
That was really good by Complexity. They had just a very, very small window. If they waited like 5 seconds longer, then Tidehunter would have already been there with the mech and then just like crushed them as they tried to engage. But Secret had to like buy time for him to get there. They tried to TP out. They used Moonlight Shadow, force them to drop sentries. That like buys them a good second. And Tiny, with the Arcane Rune, getting a couple of kills there, he's going to have his Blink Dagger. So Secret, like, they can make the move for the Roche again, but they don't have Ravage. And it's going to be low for quite some time. So
felt like one of those old Cloud Nine Roches, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, it's
our secret. Are,
it's hard now.
Yeah, that's, and Envy loves to go for the gamble sneak.
But that was a good smoke though from Complexity. Secret like were kind of prepared for it, but not completely.
It felt pretty safe. You know, they just killed the Hawk. They weren't gonna drop that low in the picks. You've untouchable to tank, but Complexity were ready to respond. So they.
It's just
to move out top.
It's one of the things about playing versus Envy. You know that he's always gonna go for the early Roche, especially if you see his item build and no Ogre Club.
Here we go. Arteezy setting up shop on the top lane, looking for the double starfall on Z-Freak, it appears. Or maybe the arrow from the trees. How will he choose to kill the Earth Spirit, or will he?
He has a lot of HP, actually. He has 660 HP and 14 stick charges, so that's not an easy kill.
Arteezy is doing that math as well, and he is not liking the odds. Meanwhile, bottom lane, PhyliDai finding Hanskin, going to work on him, 1,000 net worth Dazzle, just getting bullied by this super rich Shadow Demon with the poison stacks coming out over and over. It looks to pop him. And he will. PhyliDai, a quick and easy solo kill. I mean, you just compare these two 5-position supports, and it is not even close.
Both supports are really rich on Secret, too. Like, this is
Puppy has a Midas as well, so it's only going to get worse. 5-1-3 on the Shadow Demon.
He almost has Blink Dagger or whatever he wants to go for.
And with that, and having seen several heroes top, Secret going to take a free Roshan. This time won't be contested. Arteezy working towards the Zaganim Scepter here on the Mirana, and give him that extra bit of magic damage.
I don't necessarily agree with that move, Neuter. You'll see that a lot, the T1 trade for the Roche, but as we saw last time, like, Complexity can fight them inside of the pit, regardless of whether or not they have the Ravage and the mech up. But I think giving up Roshan is like one of the, if you can actually contest it, is one of the easiest ways to lose versus a Drow strat. So like right now, I like heavily favor Secret just because of that, although I did favor Complexity as they were running to the Roche.
Chessie now. Trying to get the hell out of the enemy jungle, Arteezy slowly stalking after him. He will go into a Shadowblade, it appears. So wants that extra bit of pick-off potential, mobility.
So the net worth near the top is pretty close, but near the bottom, like, those supports are just going to be poorer and poorer. They will die to, like, the Ags Mirana very, very soon. They can get, like, 3-shot by Impetus plus Drow Aura.
I mean, we saw Dazzle can be solo killed by the enemy Shadow Demon. So.
Yeah, and then they have the Midas on the Enchantress. And, so
and that's before the towers, which more are going to drop now. 3 towers down. It's a 2-tower and 1 Roshan advantage for Secret. Looking to make it more, but Limp trying to strike back. He can't even kill off Puppy with the point booster. Just a bit too tanky. Unable to combo him. And, you know, if he's on, if Puppy's a little bit poor, if he's down where, like, the Dazzle is, then they probably get that kill.
Yeah, and that was the Blink reveal. He had it. Like, he was spent a couple minutes farming it, too, and that's, like, kind of 4 minutes where Tiny hasn't really been able to participate in that kill. Now you have the Shadow Demon with the Blink Dagger, so things are gonna get even worse. How's Bulba looking on his item? So, Arcane Mech. Okay, he hasn't actually picked up that much past the mech, surprisingly.
Well.
Oh wow, yeah, so that's gonna be eggs. That's
a lot of items for Secret.
Yeah, Complexity, they maybe have the Shadow Blade up on the Slark, but aside from that, they're gonna need a lot more. They need like a Scepter on Tiny to get some more farm, maybe like a Veil on Earth Spirit, but these are all like
they're
10 minutes.
They're gonna chip here a little bit. They're gonna clear out this wave, and they are content having dragged several heroes back. So they retreat. Secret just hanging out in the enemy jungle. Looks like they want to play the economy game for now. They still have the Aegis here for a bit longer.
Yeah, no Lance on.
Just those top towers to be grabbed.
Really hard to siege without Lance. And they also don't have the Blink Dagger on Bulba. I think you really want to Blink Dagger this game because the supports are so weak they'll just like blow up and ravage. Plus like a leap starfall, double starfall from Mirana.
Well, you know Secret are confident when they just park their Tidehunter, only visible hero, in the mid lane, and
they have the right response. They're not all sitting in base. Like, Tiny's farming at the top lane, Slark is cutting the creep wave in the mid, so they're trying to do their best to get their farm while not losing their high ground push, but and the problem is, like, the Shadow Demon is...
Chessie can't handle the Shadow Demon, he's gotta run away.
So I think as a response, Secret should start hitting the T3, so the cores have to, are forced to go back.
Although, Chessy moving on in here is going to bring Pilot Eye very low. Disruption cooling down. Has no TP. He does get the self-disrupt off. Blink Dagger is going to be ready. Is the timing right? Yes, sirree. Chessy finding the solo kill. And meanwhile, they've also dragged Puppy in a bit too far. Secret feeding away two kills. Something Complexity will happily take and use to hang on for now. They'll use the Moonlight Shadow to try and disengage, but Limp on the chase. Chessy there with the Pouncy. Actually found him too. Do they have the detection? Z-Freak coming in hot. Avalanche is there. And with the Chuck, they get the kill. Three Secret heroes down. Limp on the double. And all of a sudden, Complexity right back in this game.
Nice blink toss to get the Enchantress, but that was very sloppy by Secret. Like Pilot Eye getting, like, he didn't have a disruption up, and very well timed Dark Pact by the Slark to finish him off. But that was like a very unorganized Secret. I think they just wanted a little bit of damage because Slark wasn't there. But they need like the Drow Ranger up in front. If she gets tossed back, she can at least survive with Aegis, and they can retreat together under the cover of the Ravage. But
yeah, I mean, Puppy found himself getting tossed all the way into the enemy Tier 4 towers. Yeah. That is not the mark of an organized siege.
They need Blink on Tide, though. I think that is a very big item that they need.
So, we'll see if that's the next choice here for Bulba. Saving up a bit of gold, but still a ways to go if he wants to grab it. Is the rest of the team going to slow things down for the moment? I believe the Aegis is gone at this point, or if not, then expiring pretty soon.
Yeah, we haven't seen too much of Morana though. So Morana's like, she already had her scepter a few minutes ago, so she is going to be hitting really hard soon. And she is number one in net worth by a small margin.
I mean, seeing that push kind of fall apart, Seeker give up a couple kills, if you're them, do you still feel a sense of urgency, or does that Morana give you enough late game insurance that you're not worried about the fact that you're running the Drow? Like, how do you see the lineups matching up later on in the game?
I think you expect the Morana to be super farmed, especially given the matchup in the mid lane, but I think more so it's like Puppy is way over farmed what you expect a Enchantress to be. She's number 5 in terms of net worth right now, just 1500 gold behind the Slark. That's very good. She's going to have Scepter very soon, plop on a Lance onto that, and then you have your second tower hitter. Not the best tower hitter, but it's still something. Because Morana can do all the magical damage, Drow can do the physical, and then you have the pure with the anti-BKB with the Enchantress. So they have most of their bases covered in the late game, and it's, you can't itemize versus that. You can't, I guess Ghost Scepter is probably the best one, but even then you have the Shadow Demon Disruption for the, or Demonic Purge for that.
Well, to try and answer that, Complexity slowly acquiring additional items here. We do see an Echo Saber out now for the Slark. Pretty close to the enemy Drow Ranger, just slightly behind, and the Tiny also close, but like you said, it is more of those supports where things are a bit more disparate. But overall, Complexity, they've done a better job of keeping the lanes pushed out. We are seeing them spread the map a little more. And I think Secret recognizing they're not choking out Complexity the way they were a couple moments ago. They do smoke, then move into a Moonlight Shadow, and they get the blink off. Initiation here onto Limp. He's going to be gusted, controlled. Z-Freak looking to save him. Ain't going to happen. They will lose the Tiny, and now perhaps more Hanskin. Will he make it out? Does TP away, and looks like he'll barely survive with the Self Grave. While this is going on, Slark pushing out the top lane.
That was pretty sloppy by Secret. They missed the arrow onto the Tiny, and then they easily could have killed more had that hit, and Bulba was kind of saving for his Rabbit. I don't think they're going to like have a large-scale team fight, especially because it's like minimum 2 minutes respawn until Roche, so I wouldn't mind if he just used that for the Dazzle, but not that big of a deal for him.
So it seems Complexity, they're really intent on the split push here. They might go for a warding mission, maybe a pickoff, but they just want to keep these lanes out, Ben. It's always the Slark on one side of the map, either the Beastmaster or the Tiny on the other. Dodging fights as much as possible before they were waiting out the Aegis, and now it seems they're just looking to farm, but bottom lane, Swindles will TP away.
They're way too weak to contest Roche, I think, now. So I think they have to make a really nice next high ground hold.
Uh-oh. Teasy not quite able to finish off Z-Freak here, and then it's Chessy's turn to try and play hard to get as he moves away, and
Bulbasaur's Ravage
might make it out. Do they want to commit that? The Dark Pact gets used again. He jumps away to the south side, and Z-Freak there with the great clutch Boulder Smash save. They both make it out successfully. Secret struggling to find what look like easy kills, but in fact are anything but. As Swindles now will get Silence. Hanskin's there behind him. He was gusted as well, but they're turning on the Pilot Eye. They want to bring down the Shadow Demon. It's a pretty big kill, as he's got quite a bit of net worth for a support there.
Yeah, they're playing this swiftly.
And they're also dodging the ganks.
Yeah, dodging the ganks, they're getting farm. They're like making Secret like react to their maneuvers and forcing them to kind of make inopportune maneuvers where they would just like to farm while Complexity's kind of huddled up in their base and then just take Roche at will and then siege high ground. That's what your game plan is at Secret. But Complexity, they're like threatening the lanes. Like the Shadowblade Slark can kill heroes if he finds them alone. I think maybe not Morana, but most of the other heroes, he can at least have a big threat, especially with Tiny off the map. So now Roshan's going to respawn pretty soon, and Complexity looking to contest that. I think off the back of the last set of moves and the farm being actually pretty close near to the top, that they can fight.
Even into the Ravage.
Yeah, Tiny has an axe. That's like very, very good.
I'm a little worried about the Tiny with the amount of kiting they have. The Frost Arrows, the Untouchable, even things like the Purge and Gush, but...
They might not be able to kill him, though. As long as he's able to, like, stick on the Drought Ranger with a Weave up on him, I think he can survive for quite some time, but I think they have to kill the Marauder early in fights, or else this Double Starfall is gonna just destroy them. They don't have any BKBs.
Well, a couple minutes later, but it's the same move from Secret. Smoking, Moonlight Shadow, both times down the mid lane, then plunging deep into the enemy jungle. They might get the jump here. Onto Handskin, moving into position. They also try to isolate Swindles, but Shadow Demon will back off. They settle for the Dazzle kill. Not catastrophic, but this could be two hero Ravage from Bulba, bringing the Beastmaster into position where Arteezy can try to focus him down. Impetus is streaming in, and Puffy not going to let his opposing captain get out without a fight. The Beastmaster drops as well. Slowly working topside. It's the Slark, but Bulba there to prevent any sort of free push. So this time Secret, they get a little more flesh with that particular move. Still, it's not a Tiny, it's not a Slark. They're not losing a true core on these ganks.
Yeah, I think Tidehunter hasn't really used that many Ravages this game. I think, like, in this situation, like, the Tidehunter has to be, like, positioned a lot more forward and a lot more willing to use Ravages just because of the way Complex is playing. If they're team fighting a lot, you don't use Ravage for solo kills. But I think, like, with the way that they're playing right now, like, they're not looking to take 5-on-5, so you can use them for kills like the Beastmaster, like we saw in that one, but more so, like, I think there was a lot of missed kill opportunity in, like, the 12 to 20 minute mark. So easy Roche, but easy T1 for Limp.
And this is where the split push game really amplifies. The Necro 3 comes out. The Aghanims, as you mentioned, already completed.
I don't know.
Getting some extra demolition tools.
Necro 3 is like the most standard build on the Beastmaster, but I don't actually know if you want to get it versus the Enchantress, because if like she can just steal it.
Take one over.
And like that's like that item is expensive. It's like 5,000 gold for Necro 3.
Even taking into account, like, he might just be using it to split push when she's not there, you still question the item.
I kind of like Vlad's a little bit more because you have two melee, you have two other melee cores,
right.
And you also...
And you're up against Drow, so...
Yeah, the armor is really useful, but that's more a personal preference. I think, like, Vlad's also helps you sustain. You can do Anxious a lot easier without the help of a Necro Book, because Tiny is sometimes searching for kills, so the Anxious won't always be taken, but that's a personal preference.
Also Secret now, moving systematically from lane to lane. They've taken down 5 outer towers, 25 minutes in. Looking for the 6th here. Complexity showing a slight desire to contest this with Swindles in the neighborhood. They have not just fully accepted the tower's death. Never mind that. The tower's dead, but they're hanging around like they want to fight. Maybe looking for a straggler. Swindles kind of creeping in. Pylite dies out a bit far. The rest of the team is there to greet him. He's keeping tabs on if Secret try to back while they leave the Slark in the bottom lane to split push. So he does get a tier 1 now, the disruption into the siege. We've seen a lot more of this lately, whether it's with the Lunas or the Medusas, Terrorblades, or in this case, the Drow Ranger. But a great gust. Envy able to lock down Limp right as he jumps in. And oh my god, that damage already almost down to critical HP. The Blake Ravage comes forth from Bulba, locking Limp down even through the Shallow Grave. They will get the kill. And now they look for more, but they've also managed to roll in and focus Envy in this fight. Still the Marana, healthy for now, chucked up and down, will end up dying. So they lose that Double Starfall that is a source of much damage for the team. But it doesn't seem to matter. They still find a secondary kill, bringing down the Tiny. It's Puppy cleaning up. Z-Freak, likely to be next, rolls away, gets the Boulder Smash back to safety, and Slark tries to join the fray, makes it so far a 2-for-2, but that was with a buyback and a dieback on the Tiny, so effectively a 2-for-3 here, and Secret are still sieging. They've already taken a melee. They will grab the range now as well. A pretty clean siege from them, and then Chessie has the misfortune to walk right into a sentry, trying to make a play for the team, ends up giving another kill. Both cores dying a collective total of 3 times in that battle. Costly for Complexity. It might just be so costly that Secret look to end the game now. 27 minutes in, We have seen a lot of this Drow Ranger nonsense the past week or so, Ben, and it appears to be just as scary as ever. Secret in their capable hands. They force out a Slark buyback. That's two core buybacks, Puppy, with the TP out. Even he gakes it home. Just extra salt in the wound here from Secret as they close in on a game one victory. It's going to be tough, but Bulba still on the run. They're going to at least try to get the Tidehunter grab here. Will they be able to? They bring him down. Still, though, Z-Freak, got to be careful. Mirana leaping forward with the Starfall, as well as the Shivas, as Arteezy overextended. He's in pretty far. The Disruption comes through to help him out. Pylai die there to save the day, but Arteezy locked down. Still too much control, too much kiting for Chessy. He can't get in close. Swindle's left to his own devices. The rest of the team scatters, and he is just going to back away as well. So they are unable to find that kill in the Mirana. Alexia really pressing here, but the Shadow Demon is quite a nuisance.
The Shivas is kind of cool on the Mirana. We don't see this very often, but I think it synergizes very well with the Starfall, because you need vision. Like, especially in that fight, like, they were all around in the trees, and flying vision is always pretty good. So yeah, Enchantress as Hurricane Pike, she was actually the main damage dealer, I think, in that last fight, with Drow being focused and Mirana dying pretty early on in that fight. But Secret, they're playing pretty systematically. They have sentries to cover the bases in case the Slark tries to come from behind. They use the illusions from the disruption to try and tank the blink toss. Tiny actually tossed an illusion back instead of the Drow Ranger. I'm sure she would have loved to get the Drow Ranger like back to the T4s, but that was not possible because of their setup. So they're covering all their bases, just making sure that the most ridiculous ways for them to lose a fight are kind of eliminated, and Complexity have to just straight take a 5-on-5 with someone getting roared and, you know, heroes actually fighting each other instead of one hero getting super isolated.
Now Z-Freak looking to make a play here on Puppy, but he just calmly pikes himself away. And we'll move back to the mid lane now. So if you're Complexity here, you're looking at a very likely second lane of Rax being attempted. You lack buybacks in your cores. Ravage is now up.
Try and stall for 20 seconds. You try and time the kill so that he dies when his Aegis is about to expire. They have like 15 seconds, I think.
I think they're going to lose a Rax by then, Ben, if they do wait, but...
You can start the fight right now and just try and hold off a
little bit. They may have no choice. Arteezy's the one to start it, though. They get eyes on Limp. They're going to focus him down. He will be grave from the high ground, but Swindle's getting caught out here. Silence after the Ravage. The follow-up comes through. Z-Freak not dead yet, but very, very low. Has to turn tail. Has to run away. The disruption preventing a full retreat. Swindle's will drop. The rest likely to follow soon, along with the Rex, I should say. His handskin almost gets pierced by those Puppy impetuses, single-handedly mowing down Complexity heroes. This is like shooting fish in a barrel at this point for El Capitan and Secret. Two lanes of Rex, already focusing tier 4 tower, skipping that bottom lane entirely. They feel the game's in hand, and truth be told, I don't think there are many people at home who would disagree.
That's a pretty cool strategy by Secret. I think like they wanted the armor on like the Dazzle, but Dazzle was actually like very useless this game. Like the Graves helped a little bit, but I like the super varied damage types from Secret. I liked how Puppy ended up getting a lot of farm while still doing a lot of damage early, and I think Limp performed particularly well on the Tiny. He, I think, performed much better than I expected in the middle lane, and they showed some signs of life before they contested first Rosh, but after that it was all downhill, and Secret's looking pretty decent shape. Well, it's a Drow strat though, so.